Hi, Daryl here from Chinabi Toys. I am back again for another video. Today we're gonna do a demo of Tesla Vision Autopilot. Our Model Y came out this June. It didn't came with radar compared to the previous Model Ys that with radar. Since Tesla now is transitioning into camera only sensor for the autopilot. So let's see how it performs in an actual road trip. Hope you guys enjoy the video.
To activate the autopilot is you have to pull this lever, which is the gear shifter in Tesla, twice, nice and quick. One, two. And you see the blue right there, the blue steering wheel and the blue speed limit. That means your autopilot is engaged, and you can see this two blue line. That's your lane. That means it's engaged. Once you turn it off, if you want to turn it off, you just raise up gear shifter. There you go. And you see there's no more blue line. That means the autopilot is disabled. If you just want to enable the cruise control, just pull the gear shifter. One, there we go. And your speed limit is set to 70. You can adjust it by using the wheel on the steering wheel, going up to increase and going down to decrease. And for the distance of the car, left and right, you can see right here, five spaces. And you can go up to 3, and I think you can go up to 7. We're just gonna go to 3. And if you wanna activate the autopilot, again, pull gear shifter twice. There you go, and it's enabled. There's so many ways in deactivating the autopilot or the cruise control. One, if you wanna deactivate autopilot and cruise control at the same time, raise the gear shifter up or press the brake pedal slightly. That will disable the autopilot and cruise control. Now, if you're gonna change lane, if you only have an autopilot, you don't have the autonomous system. If you wanna change lane, if you turn on your blinker, it will disable autopilot, but the cruise control will remain active. That means you can steer the car to change lane, and then you can, once you are in your designated lane, you can enable the autopilot again. You can also disable the autopilot by wiggling the steering wheel hard enough. It will disengage the autopilot. And again, once you're in the autopilot, always pay attention to the road and also the surrounding of your car. And always be ready to take over. No hands. And I'm not stepping on the brakes or on the accelerator. The car is it's driving by itself. This is a good thing if you are tired from work. You can just relax and have the car drive you home. But make sure you're paying attention on the road. If something happens, you won't be able to take control. So right now is the car is telling me to put pressure on the steering wheel because it didn't detect my hand. So I just put my hand for a couple of seconds, put a little bit of pressure, and there you go. The warning disappeared. Or the car just wanted to make sure that you're still awake, you're not asleep, and you're paying attention on the road. And also the camera here, Elon Musk just enabled it to monitor you if you are paying attention on the road or if you're asleep. The upgrade came in yesterday, and I just upgraded the software in the car, and I think it's active now. So what will happen, I think what will happen is the same thing as the warning on the steering wheel, but once the camera sees you, you're not paying attention on the road or you're asleep, the car will automatically turn on its hazard light, and it will just slow down. You won't be able to turn on the autopilot. So you'll be put in autopilot jail. Yeah, your autopilot will be disabled until you reach your destination. So far, so good. The Tesla Vision without radar is working flawlessly in our car. So it's keeping us in the middle of the lane. It's sensing the car in front of us, and it brakes and also accelerates. In short, it's driving itself perfectly. That one, the car is the one braking. I'm not even putting my right foot on the brake pedal or accelerator.
I tested the Tesla Vision Autopilot around 68 to 69 miles on a curb, and it did pretty well. And there's one instant that the car gave me several warnings to put my hands on the steering wheel, because there were tons of construction cones on the side of the road, so probably the car detected there's a construction going on, even though there's no construction worker. So the car prompted me and slowed down to 50 miles. And also, on the last part of this clip, I was testing the camera on top of the back view mirror, if it's working. I tried covering my eyes by my baseball cap. I was wearing a cap on that one, and tried closing my eyes, and it did prompt me several times. So the camera is actually working, and maybe by this we can prevent further incident of people falling asleep or intentionally falling asleep and moving to the passenger side. This is the front that I was talking. First, I closed my eyes for a couple of seconds and the car prompted me. And the second warning, I used my baseball cap to cover my eyes so that the camera will not see my eyes. And again, it prompted me. My wife told me that the car will be reminding me to stay awake or pay attention to the road because of my small eyes, and the car might mistake that I'm sleeping. I think that's all for now. I hope you guys learned something. And if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. And don't forget to leave a comment and like. Also, if you know someone is trying to buy a Tesla, or you're trying to buy a Tesla, you can use our referral code so that we can have 1,000 miles free of supercharging. Thank you for watching. Until next time. Bye-bye.